It was good. You know, it was our last regular season meet. It was a little hot out there out in Fargo. I think it was close to 80. But, you know, we got out there and everyone kind of competed to the best of their ability. I was really happy with what we saw across the board. I think it was our last chance to kind of shake out any cobwebs of before the conference championships.
How about, you know, Jacob sets the school record and then 20 minutes later, Tanner takes him down.
Yeah.
How cool is that to have each of those two guys pushing each other?
Sure. I think, you know, they push each other on a daily basis in practice. And so it's nice to kind of see that kind of like friendly rivalry continue out in Fargo. But no, it was super exciting. You know, we got the word because Hammer was a little bit of ways away from the rest of the track facility. So we got word that Jake had broken the school record, and then, you know, not even like 20 minutes later, you know, we got word that Tanner had, on his very last attempt, re-broke the school record on the same day. So, you know, kudos to them, and, you know, all their hard work, I think, is beginning to pay off.
All right, so this is your first outdoor championship as the Minot State head coach. So what is your message to the team this week?
Well, I think it's the same, you know, kind of following up indoors is, you know, when you go to the conference championships, you know, you're there to compete, to score points. You know, you're not necessarily there for like a PR or, you know, your best throw or, you know, best mark in like a jump. But, you know, we want to go there and compete and try to get in the top eight and score some points so that, you know, we can finish higher up in the team standing. So, I think we've made some tremendous progress between the indoor championships and coming into the outdoor championships. So I'm very excited to kind of see where that puts us, you know, in the team standings.
All right, let's start with the guys. Tell me some of the guys that you expect to perform well and that you're hopeful will score in the top eight.
Well, I think the field events group, which, you know, they've carried the team, you know, the majority of the season, and our javelin and hammer throw groups are ranked within the top 20 in the country. So, you know, I expect them to put up some big points. You know, Tanner and Jake, Ben, Derek Wax, you know, they'll be in the javelin. So I think they're both in the top five. So, you know, I'm expecting to kind of pick up some points where maybe some people, other coaches or teams in the conference, you know, don't really see us coming. You know, Daniel Davenrud and Josh Drew, they've both been ranked at one point in the season in the top 10. So, you know, we're hoping that they can perform really well on the day and get into the final and score some points. And then in our distance events, you know, we've come a long way since January. So we'll have Dante Gadboy and Colin Olson in the middle distance in the 1500 and the 800. And then Devin Chumway and Stephen Porter in the 5K and the 10K. So, you know, we're hoping, you know, on the right day, you know, anything can happen. You know, I think I heard it's supposed to rain on Friday, and, you know, the elements always kind of switch things up, unlike indoors. You know, it's you know, always 50 degrees and, you know, and things like that. But, you know, with the rain and things like that, you never know if people will wither, you know, obviously. Watching the Boston Marathon, you know, a few weeks ago, you know, anything can happen. So we're hoping maybe that plays to our advantage come Friday and Saturday.
How about on the women's side?
Again, I think, you know, Amber Hunsaker, she's ranked first in the javelin throw. And, you know, we're obviously hoping that she can, you know, keep that spot and be atop the podium come this weekend. And she'll also be in the shot put and the hammer throw. So, I believe, you know, we had our staff meeting this morning and we're projecting, you know, hopefully she can sneak out a few points for us there. Sam Huther, this will be her final go around as a senior in the steeple. I know she has high aspirations and we have high aspirations for her. So we're hoping, you know, she can sneak into the top five. You know, she's really coming around. She had a big race on Friday in Fargo. I believe it was a 17-second season best in the 1500. So I think she's running her best at the right time. So, you know, and again, we're very young on the women's side. Unlike the men, are a little bit older. So you never know what can happen, right? You know, we'll have Brinley Nielsen and Abigail McGee in the 800, and it'll be their second conference championships after the indoor season. But we're just hoping, you know, they can go out there and compete to the best of their ability. And, you know, hopefully on the day they can sneak into the final.
How important is this as you start to build the program to, obviously, you know, you want to finish in the top five or whatever, but how important is it just to show improvement for this conference championship?
I think this conference championship will be a springboard to next year, you know, and hopefully it'll generate some excitement amongst the team, amongst the athletic department and the university. But I think, yeah, just as a team, it, hopefully it's a springboard to, you know, they can hopefully see what's to come down the road, you know, next winter and, you know, next spring. And, you know, we're excited to kind of see how far we've come. I think, you know, we've improved tremendously. I think the mindset has changed a little bit. So, you know, we'll see, you know, come Friday and Saturday where that puts us. But as far as going forward, you know, hopefully, like I said, it generates some excitement amongst them. You know, it's hard. I think in today's day and age, everyone wants improvement now. And, you know, maybe at times it seems hard to think long term, but, you know, they've fully bought in. And so, you know, I think in the years to come, it, you know, like I said, on the women's side, we're a little young. You know, hopefully it gives that some excitement of, you know, where we can be in, you know, 2 or 3 years.
So the last thing, obviously the ultimate excitement creator is making the NCAA championships.
For sure.
Where are the people that have provisionally qualified? Where are...
So right now we have two. Amber is, I believe, 32nd in the javelin throw. She needs to throw about 2 meters further, and she'll be, you know, she'll be in the top 20. And Tanner, you know, he's on the list, but I think he'll have to throw a little bit further to get in for the hammer throw. I mean, just I think to get on the list and to hit a provisional qualifying mark just changes the athlete's mindset in terms of, you know, it sets the bar higher for themselves. It you know, gets them thinking bigger picture, things like that. But they'll both need to improve on their marks. You know, typically they'll take 18 to 20 to the outdoor championships. So, you know, this will be their final go around this weekend, you know, to try and improve on that.